Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh dan salam sejahtera. Okay, so our topic here is circular measure. Okay, so adjective here, convert the angle degree into radian and vice versa. Okay, so untuk sudut ni there are two units, one is radian and one is degree. Okay, so macam panjang lah, so panjang kita ada meter, sentimeter, kilometer. So macam tu juga dengan angle. So angle there are two unit, which is degree and radian. And in circular measure usually we use radian. Okay. And then find the length of arc of a circle and calculate the area of sector of a circle. So apa itu arc, apa itu circle? So arc tu adalah sebahagian daripada circumference. Okay, so ni circle. So yang kat sini ni, katakan kita ambil sebahagian sahaja. So this one we call it arc. Okay, so this one small. So this one small, it is minor arc. For the bigger one, this one is the major arc. Okay. And for the sector, this is a circle. Okay, so sebahagian daripada circle ni. Okay, so if we take this one, okay, so yang ni we call it as sector. Sebahagian daripada bulat. Okay, and this one is the small one. So this one is the minor sector. And the bigger one, this one. Okay, so this one is the major sector. Okay. Okay, so for the sector, we calculate the area. Okay, so convert radian into degree and vice versa. Okay, so we know that 360 degree it is equal to 2 pi radian and 180 degree is equal to pi radian. So therefore 1 radian is equal to 180 degree divided by pi. So this one times by 1, so 1 pi. So pi pindah ke sebelah jadi bahagi. So 1 radian is equal to 180 degree divided by pi. Okay, so to convert radian into degree or degree into radian, okay, so it is enough for you to remember this formula. So x radian divided by pi radian, it is equal to y degree divided by 180 degree. Okay, so saya fokus pada formula yang ni sebabnya nanti takkan pening-pening. So kalau korang nak pakai radian into degree formula lain, degree into radian formula lain, so kena hafal dua formula. So this one satu ni je. Okay, so let's say you want to convert degree into radian. So nanti korang masukkan apa yang degree, lepas tu kira yang radian. Okay, example lah, senang cerita, kita tengok example. Okay, so this one. Okay, so convert each of the following angle 2 degrees and vice versa. So this one, radian into degree. Okay, so we have over pi radian is equal to apa yang dekat atas over 180 degree. So the question given is 5 pi over 3. So here 5 pi over 3 radian, it is equal to so kat sini angle in degree that we need to find. So just write down y. Tak kisahlah nak tulis y ataupun x. So yang sebelah missing ni kita akan tulis dalam bentuk variable. So from this formula, so we have 5 pi over 3 divided by pi. So this one bring to the left, multiply by 180. So it is equal to y. So therefore y it is equal to berapa tu? So kira. So 5 pi over 3 divided by pi. Okay, so dalam kalkulator korang tulislah ni dalam bracket, and then this one change into bahagi. So become 5 over 3. Okay, and then calculate. So you have y it is equal to 300 degree. Then for the second one, okay, so same, 1.5 pi radian divided by pi radian, it is equal to y divided by 180 degree. Okay, and then this one bring to the left, so you will have 1.5 pi divided by pi times by 180, it is equal to y. So y it is equal to 270 degree. And then next, okay, so 120 degree into radian. Okay, so this one A and this one is B. Okay, so for the C, okay, so formula tadi apa, bahagikan dengan pi radian, it is equal to what divided by 180 degree. So given is 120 degree. So 120 degree we put above 180. So jangan letak atas pi. Okay. Sebab sini akan kurang letak atas ni 120 degree. So degree radian. Nak apalnya senang lah. So yang atas ni radian, bawah ni pun radian. Yang sini pun sama, atas degree, bawah pun degree. So given 120 degree, so therefore 120 degree put on the right, okay? So 120 degree. So this one we need to find. So put y. So y is equal to 120 divided by 180 times by pi. Okay, so 120 divided by 180, so it is equal to 2 over 3. Okay, so the answer is 2 over 3 pi radian. Okay, so biasanya tinggal dalam bentuk pi je lah. Tak payah lah nak kira yang pi tu. And then another one for the D. Okay, so again, so y over pi radian, it is equal to 15 degree divided by 180 degree. So we have y is equal to 315 degree divided by 180 degree times by pi. So this equal to 7 over 4 pi radian. Okay. So next, length of arc of a circle. Okay, so length of arc of a circle, this one S. Okay, so it is given by S equal to R times by theta. So the radius times by angle. So this angle must be in radian. And here, just now already, I already told you, the small one is the minor arc, and the bigger one we call it as the major arc. Okay. Okay. So example here. So the diagram below shows a sector, so a sector with radius 4 cm, and angle AOB, so AOB which is 1.5 radian. So find the length of arc AB. Okay, so length of arc AB so using formula R theta is equal to R theta. So radius is 4 and theta is 1.5 radian. So it is equal to 6 centimeter. Okay. So another example, find the length of major arc AB of the circle below. So major arc, yang ni, this one, the biggest one. But the angle given is for the minor arc. So therefore for the major arc, the angle is 360, 620. So which is equal to 240. Okay, so this one in degree, but the theta is in radian. So the angle must be in radian. So convert into radian. So y over pi radian, it is equal to 240 degree divided by 180 degree. So y, it is equal to 240 over 180 pi. Okay, so 240 divided by 180. Okay, so it is equal to 4 over 3 pi. Okay, so after that, find the length of major arc AB. So it is equal to R theta. So R is 5 cm and theta is 4 over 3 pi radian. So the answer is 20.94 cm. Okay, so next example. Okay, so ni tak ada gambar aja. Okay, so the question, the length of an arc of a sector with radius of it 13.75. So, dia ada satu sektor. Okay, so radius 8 cm and the length of arc is 13.75. Okay, so find the angle subtended by the arc at the center in the radian. So, nak cari theta ni. Okay, so using the formula S is equal to R theta. So, S is 13.75. Radius is 8 and theta we need to find. So, theta it is equal to 13.75. Okay, so this 8 bring to the left become divide. Okay, so divide by 8. So, we have the answer which is equal to 1.719. So, 1.719 radian. Okay, so another example. An arc with a length of 40 cm subtends an angle 160 at the center of a circle. So, find the diameter of the circle. Okay, so ni circle. So, angle here is 160 and the length of the arc which is related to this 160 is 14 cm. So, to find the diameter. Okay, so to find the diameter, we need the value of R. So, because diameter is 2R. Okay, so diameter is 2 radius, 2 times radius. Okay. So, to find R, so we need this angle in radian. So, convert into radian. So, y over pi radian, it is equal to 160 divided by 180. So, y is equal to 160 over 180. Okay, so, 160 over 180 times with pi. So, the answer is 8 over 9 pi. Then, substitute into the formula S is equal to R theta. So, S is 14. R we need to find. So, theta is 8 over 9 pi. So, here multiplication. So, bring to the left. So, we have R equal to 14 divided by 8 over 9 pi. So, it is equal to 5.013 cm. So diameter it is equal to 5.013 times by 2. So it is equal to 10.026 cm. Okay, so next. So the diagram above shows two arcs PS and QR. So PS and QR of two sector with center zero, center O, and having radius OP, OP and OQ. So find angle theta in radian. So theta. Okay, so to find theta, given here length of arc. Okay, so 7 cm. So we can use the S is equal to R theta. So S is 7. It is equal to R. So radius for arc QR is 6 plus by 3, which is 9, times with theta. So theta it is equal to 7 divided by 9. So the answer is 0.77 8 ataupun just leave it 7 over 9 lah. Okay, so 7 over 9 radian. And then perimeter of the shaded region. Okay, so to find the perimeter of shaded region, so it is equal to PQ, length PQ, plus RQR, plus length RS, and then plus up of PS. Okay, so yang kita dah ada PQ, QR dan SR. So therefore, we need to find the length of arc PS. Okay, so length of arc PS. Okay, so it is equal to R theta. Okay, so for the PS, R is 6 cm. And theta is, this one theta, so which is 7 over 9. So therefore, we have PS, which is 14 over 3. 6 times 7 over 9. Okay, so 14 over 3 centimeter. Okay, so next, perimeter. So therefore, perimeter of shaded region. So it is equal to 3 plus 7 plus 3. Okay, so this 3 is PQ. Okay, so PQ, 7 is RQR. And then this 3 is RS. And then plus RPS. So plus 14 over 3. So we have the answer, which is 13 plus 14 over 3. So 53 over 3 centimeter. Okay, so next we go to the area of sector of a circle. Okay, so area of a sector of a circle, it is given by 1 over 2 R square theta. Okay, so A area of sector. So sector AOB, so AOB, so yang blurry ni. And then R is the radius and theta is angle in radian. Okay, so this one is the small one, is the minor sector. And the bigger one is the major sector. Okay, so example here. Find the area of the minor sector AOB. So minor sector AOB, so the small one. Okay, so we have A area, which is equal to 1 over 2 R square theta. So it is equal to 1 over 2. R is 7. 7 square theta is 1.5. So the answer is 36.75 centimeter square. Okay, so next example, find the area of the shaded region. Okay, shaded region is the major one, the biggest one. Okay, so the angle given is 30 degree. So therefore, we need to find the angle of the shaded region, this one, which is 360 minus 30. So it is equal to 330. Okay, so but this angle in degree, so we need to change into radian. So we use y divided by pi, it is equal to 330 degree divided by 180 degree. So we have y is equal to 330 divided by 180 times by pi. Okay, so y is equal to 5.76 radian. Okay, yes, after that. Okay, so we have already have the angle, so find the area. So area, it is equal to radius, so it is equal to 1 over 2 R square times by theta. So 1 over 2 R is, so 9 power of 2, and theta is 5.76. Okay, so it is equal to 233 and 28 centimeter square. Okay, so next, a sector of a circle is 5 centimeter has an area of 24.5 centimeter. So find the angle of the sector in radius. Okay, so kita ada satu sektor. So lukis sektor tu kalau yang tak nampak ya. So sektor ada theta angle and then radius 5 cm and the area of the sector is 24.5. Okay, so and then substitute into formula area equal to 1 over 2 r square theta. Okay, so area is 24.5 1 over 2 radius is 5 square and theta. Okay, so calculate 5 square 25, so 25 times 1 over 2, so become 25 over 2 theta. Okay, so 2 brings here, so 2 times 24.5 is equal to 25 theta. So theta, it is equal to 2 times 24.5 divided by 25. Okay, so it is equal to 1.96 radian. Okay, so kalau nak buat macam ni boleh ke? So from this one, 24.5, so you here multiplication, so bring to the left become divide. So boleh je. So theta is equal to 24.5 divided by 25 over 2. Put bracket this one. Okay, so the answer should be same, 1.96 radian. Okay. Okay, so next, this one, last one. Okay, so next, in figure below, the length of the arc of two circle KNLM, so KNLM, subtended by a circle, so this one by bukan B, okay, by a center angle, okay, so center angle dekat center ni is 4P and 5P respectively. So given the angle theta is 2 radian, okay, so this one 2 radian, and the area of KLMN, so area of this one is 81. Okay, so theta is 2 radian. Okay, so 2 radian. Okay, so calculate the value of P. Okay, so we have here arc. Okay, so length of arc for P and 5P. Okay, so from the formula of length of arc, so we have S is equal to R theta. Okay, so for the S we have 4P. So 4P is equal to R theta, so theta is 2R. And for the 5P, also same, theta is 2 and here R. So R actually R1 and R2 lah sebab dia berbeza. Okay, so for the 4P R is from O to K. For the 5P, the radius is from O until L. Okay, so this one actually equation number 1 and equation number 2. So nak selesaikan P ni nanti kita pakai apa kata simultaneous equation lah. Okay, so before that, cuma R1, R2 ni berbeza. Macam mana kita nak buat? Okay, so we need to let. Okay, so let's say the radius here is, kau tak boleh juga sebab tak tahu panjang sini berapa, okey. So bolehlah pakai R1. So this one is R1. Nak pakai X pun bolehlah, X. And here from 0 until L is Y. Okey. Okay, so therefore for A, so you will have for P, it is equal to 2X, and 5P, it is equal to 2Y. Okay, and then you do it 1 divided by 2. Okay, so from 1 divided by 2, so you will have 4p divided by 5p. It is equal to 2x divided by 2y. Okay. So this one cancel. P and P also cancel. So you will have x over y, it is equal to 4 over 5. So x, it is equal to 4 over 5, y. Okay, so ni saya dapat x dengan y. Ya, betul. Okay, so macam mana nak cari P? So we need to calculate x or y first. Okay, so from given area. Okay, so area this one, 81. Okay, so area is equal to 81. Okay, so area is equal to 81. So to obtain 81, it is equal to area of the biggest sector. So area of sector OLM minus by the small sector, which is area of OKN, it is equal to 81. So substitute the area for OLM. Formula dia OLM, so which is 1 over 2 R square. So for the OLM, R is Y square, and then theta. So theta is 2. Then minus area of OKN. OKN. So 1 over 2 X square, and N is N pula theta. So theta is 2. So it is equal to 80. So 1 over 2 times by 2 become 1. So only left is y square. And here also same. So 1 over 2 times by 2 become 1. So only left x square. It is equal to 81. And from this one, we have x equal to 4 over 5y. So substitute into this one. So you will have y square minus by 4 over 5y square is equal to 81. Yes, after that, calculate this one, 4 over 5 y square. So y square minus 16 over 25 y is equal to 81. So 1 minus 16 over 25, it is equal to 9 over 25. So 9 over 25 y square is equal to 81. So 9 over 25 this one bring to the right. Yeah. So kita bawa yang nombor dulu. So tak boleh bawa kuasa 2 because this 2 power of 2 is only for y. It is not for 9 over 25. Okay, so kuasa 2 hanya pada y. So dia bukan untuk 9 per 25. So kuasa 2 tak boleh pindah ke sebelah. Tapi 9 per 25, this one, for all of this one. Untuk kesemua y kuasa 2. So, korang boleh pindah 9 per 25. Okay, so therefore, so we have here, y square is equal to 81, since here multiplication. So, bring to the right become divide. So, divide over 9 over 25. Okay, so it is equal to, so y square is equal to 225. So y is equal to square root of 225. So it is equal to 15. So y is equal to 15. So after you obtain y, okay, so substitute into equation number 2. So this one, untuk cari p. Sebab kat sini 5p is equal to 2y. Okay. So from equation number 2, so we have 5p is equal to 2 times by y, which is 15. So p is equal to 2 times 15, 30, and then divide by 5. So we have the value of p, which is 6. Okay. So dah dapat nilai p. Okay, so after that, b, calculate the length of arc KNN LM. Okay, so arc, so length of arc. Arc KN. Okay, so untuk KN. So KN is 4P. Okay. So yang ni korang tak payahlah masuk formula S equal to R theta, because you already have 4P. Okay, so dah ada value untuk. So KN is 4P. So 4 times by P, which is 6. So we have 4 times by 6, 24 centimeter. And length of arc LN, LM. So for the LM, it is equal to 5P. So 5 times by 6. So the answer is 30 centimeter. Okay, so kita dah ada P. So saya tulis semula ke atas. Tadi kita dah dapat P, which is 6. And then 4P, 24. 5P is equal to 30. And then, apa lagi tadi? Y. So, Y is equal to 6. Betul? Y pula. Y equal to 15. Okay, so Y is equal to 15. And then, it is equal to 4 over 5Y. Okay, so ni. X is equal to 4 over 5Y. Okay. Yes. So, kita dah dapat B, dah siap. And then C, find the perimeter of KLMN. So, KLMN. So, for the KLMN, so we have the length here, 5P. And length of this one, which is 4P. Okay, so 30 and 24. So, only left, we need to find the length of KL. So, in order to find the length of KL, so we need the length of Y and the length of X. So that's why saya ambil Y, ambil X. So yang ni pun saya ambil, dan P pun saya ambil. Okay, sebab saya nak pakai dekat C. Okay, so saya delete. Okay, so find X. So Y is 15. So X is to 4 over times by 15. So it is equal to 1, 3. Is equal to 12 cm. So therefore the length of KL, so KL is equal to 15 minus by 12, which is equal to 3 cm. Okay, so NM also same with KL. Okay, so therefore perimeter of KLN, KLMN it is equal to 3 plus 5P plus another 3, so which is NM, and plus 4P. So it is equal to 3, 5P which is equal to 30, and 3, and then plus 4P which is 24. So the answer is 60 cm. Okay, dah habis. Okay, so that's all for our lesson today. So see you later. Thank you and Assalamualaikum.